name's Kelly Barton. I work for a national sight loss charity called Thomas Pocklington Trust. In our engagement team, we have a brand called Sight Loss Council. So there's about 20 sight loss councils up and down the country, and they're all made up of blind and partially sighted volunteers who are working towards making positive change in their local area. So trying to make organisations and services more inclusive and accessible for people who've got sight loss. So we've been working with Sefton Council. We invite people to come in and we talk to them about the challenges and the barriers that people who are blind and partially sighted face. And then we basically get them to put on simulation glasses which simulate different eye conditions. And they then go in pairs and they walk outside. So we go on sort of an hour's walk with them in the local area so that they can understand the challenges that we face when we're out and about, as people who've got sight loss. So things like uneven pavements, overhanging bushes, just the general difficulties on the street, things like pavement parking, when you've got cafes that come quite far out into the street with street furniture. We've done three of these sessions and we've had people from the highways team, public protection, people who are kind of involved in street design, just to help them have a better understanding of the challenges that we face, but also where areas are possible, where it works well. So streets where actually this is a good way for it to be. So we try and bring the positives as well for people so that we can highlight to them good practice as well as, what could do to be improved and what would help us as people who can't see when they're trying to navigate the area with using a long cane or a guide dog.
Well, I got involved with the Sight Loss Council about 18 months ago. It gives me an opportunity to make a difference. So attending meetings like today, getting involved with transport planning and educating people and informing people as to how we want to be treated by society at large. Last Tuesday I was walking up South Road in Waterloo and there's temporary fencing outside icing if you know there it's by Waterloo Station, and because you had the rails near the crossing it was just not possible to walk into the road and do anything. You had to do a massive detour and it means crossing a potentially dangerous road. Now I know work has to happen but it can be frustrating. That's just one recent example.
I think the fact that we've had almost 60 people on these courses now, so I think that's really positive. And in November we're going to do a reflection session, so some people are going to come back and tell us what they've changed within their job roles, because that's really important to us. So it's all very well delivering sessions like this, but what we want to do is to see what impact that's having and how people are changing their practice within their job role to make to make it a better experience for people who are blind or partially sighted.
Thomas Pocklington Trust and Sight Loss Council's logos. Sefton Council logo. www.sefton.gov.uk